Hello my lovely kids, welcome to today's session. Which number we are learning? We are learning number 0. And what does number 0 denotes? Number 0 denotes no object or nothing. Kids, now let us see a video related to number 0 to understand its value.
Snow was falling from the sky, and there were sparkling snowflakes all around. They were all different and all beautiful. There were hundreds and thousands of them. But they melted in the sun. They ended up as steam, which disappeared too. How do we say that there are no snowflakes in the sky? We have a special number that will help us. Meet the number 0. Spring is here. Snow and ice melted in the sun. In spring, rain falls from the clouds. Spring rain goes away soon, and tiny raindrops end up in lakes. How do we say there are no raindrops in the sky? The number 0 is there to help us again. Spring is in the air, and so are the twitters and chatter of birds. The seagulls are relaxing in the water. The birds flew away. How do we say that there are no birds in the water? The number 0 is just what we need, because 0 represents absence of a thing. We use all other numbers when we can see some snowflakes, raindrops, birds, or other objects. We use 0 when there are no objects at all.
Kids, I hope through this video you have understood the value of number 0. Now, we will revise the position of number 0 in the number line. Number 0 is written before number 1, right? So, let us revise numbers once again, 0 to 10. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and last number 1, 0, 10. So 0 is written before 1 and 0 can be written after any number, like it is written over here, 1, 0, 10. Now we will revise how to spell number 0. So let us start. Number 0, Z, E, R, O, 0. Let us do it once again. Number 0. Z, E, R, O, 0. Kids, now we will trace number 0 using our finger, and we will also sing a song of number 0 which I taught you yesterday. So let us start. We will start from this point. We will make a forward curve, come down, and then we will make a reverse curve. So now let us trace with our finger and sing the number 0 song. Round we go, round we go. That's the way we make a 0. Once again we will start. Around we go, around we go. That's the way we make a 0. Now kids, we will revise how to write number 0 on our own. So first we will make a forward curve, come down and make a reverse curve. Once again, forward curve, come down and make a reverse curve. Once again, forward curve, come down, reverse curve. Forward curve, come down, reverse curve. Forward curve, come down and make a reverse curve. Now kids, I will show you the solution of the worksheet which I explained you yesterday. So in this first exercise of the worksheet, we have to circle the child with 0 balloon, right? So what is this first child having? How many balloons is he having? Let us count. 1, 2, 3. So he is having 3 balloon. So will we circle this child? No, we won't circle this child as he is already having balloons. Now let us see the second child. Now second child, can you see any balloons in her hand? No, she is not having any balloon. So can we say the child is having 0 balloon? Yes. So we will make a circle around the child as this child is having 0 balloon. So now I am making a circle right. Now let us see over here the third child. The third child is having how many balloons in her hand? She is having 1 balloon in her hand. So we won't circle this child. And this another child, how many balloon is he having in his hand? Let us count. 1 and 2. So we won't make a circle around this child also. And the last child, what is he having in his hand? What do you see? He is having a flower in his hand. So can we say this child is having 0 object in his hand? No, the child is not having a balloon in his hand, but child is having a flower. So we cannot circle this child either, because when do we use 0? When there is no object or nothing, but the child is having a flower. So we won't circle this child. Now let us go to the second exercise. In this second exercise, there are 1, 2, and 3 trees. Now we have to cross the tree with 0 apple on it. So let us see the first tree. In the first tree, we can see there are many apples. So let us count the apples. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. This tree is having 9 apples. So we won't make a cross on this tree as it is having 9 apples. So now let us move to the second tree. Now how many apples does this tree have on it? So let us count. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So we won't make a cross on this tree also, as this tree is having 5 apples on it. Now let us see the last tree. Can you see any apples on this tree, kids? No. So we can say there are 0 apples on this tree. So what we will do? We will make a cross on it. And do you know how to make a cross? I will teach you how to make a cross. Make one slant line and another slant line. That's how we make a cross. Now let us move to the last exercise. In this exercise, we have to draw a square around the cage having 0 word, right? So in this first cage, how many birds do you see, kids? Let us count. There are 1 and 2 birds in this cage. So can we make a square around this cage? No, we cannot make a square. Now let us move to the second cage. Now what do you see over here? In this cage, we can see 1 bird inside the cage. So there is 1 bird inside. So we cannot make a square around this cage also. And now the last cage. Is this cage having any birds? No, there are no birds inside. So what do we say? We say there are 0 birds inside the cage, because both the birds have flew away from the cage. So we will make a square around this last cage. So now I will teach you how to draw a square, right? So for making a square, we will make a standing line, sleeping line, one more standing line on this side, and one more sleeping line. So now we have completed our worksheet. I hope, kid, through this video you have understood the position and value of number 0. Now you can revise number 0 by viewing this video again. So bye, kids, see you next time.